Hello, my dear students. I hope you all are doing great. Today is day 3 of our Redemption of Debentures chapter. And I'm sure you're understanding what we are doing. We, in the first lecture, had seen about what are debentures, the DRR related, the DRRI, how the legal provisions go about it, etc., etc. Then we went for the own debentures purchased. In own debentures purchased, we had mainly just two entries which we were passing. One was own debentures purchased entry, that is own debentures account debit, interest on debentures account debit to bank, and then when you cancel those debentures, you have a profit on cancellation. Then we had debentures account debit to own debentures and any profit to profit on cancellation. Basically, two entries what we were revolving around. And like I told you in the last lecture, today's lecture is going to be one level up. And therefore, now let's start straight away. Remember, we are doing our ICI module sums only. This should be quite enough to cover all your concepts. And for practice, you can use the recent mock test papers or the recent RTP questions. Please don't go to the old ones because the answers would be different in the old one. So let's now go to problem number 7. Problem 6 we'll do last in this type. Problem number 7, let's analyze first. Okay. A company had 16,000 12% debentures of 100 each outstanding on 1st April 1. So first, like I always say, look at your dates properly. So 1st April 1 is my starting point, which is redeemable on 31st March 2. So they are due for redemption. On 1st April, the following balances appeared in the books of accounts. We have investment in 2009% secured government bonds of 100 each. So 2000 bonds of 100 each, 2 lakh investments I'm having. The DRR is 2.5 lakh. Interest on investment is received yearly at the end of the financial year. Okay. The moment I see DRR, the moment I say DRRI, I have to have my bell ringing there. What do I see? How many debentures? 16,000 into 100. I have 16 lakh debentures. So 16 lakh into 25% should be the DRR. Let me see. DRR is 2.5 and 25% of 16 lakh will be 4 lakh. So I can clearly see a hidden adjustment here. I will need to take care of my extra amount. I have to create that much amount of DRR, which I will do it on 1st April itself. Plus, then I have to also see my investments. Investments are 2000 into 100, 2 lakh. Calculate now. Debentures are 16 lakh into 15%. Should be 2,40,000. And there I have only 2 lakh investments, so I need to make extra investments also. So why this sum is important, you can star mark, is that it has got less DRR, less DRRI, which is not even apparently visible. It is a hidden adjustment. And you, my dear, have to be careful about this adjustment. So this, in the first paragraph, I have analyzed. Then, with DRR, DRRI, now they insert one more adjustment. 2000 owned debentures were purchased on 31st March 12 at an average price of 99 rupees and cancelled on the same date. Okay, so they purchased on 31st March only and they cancelled it. I guess you should just change this to 2000 x2, make it 2000 x2. Okay, and 99 rupees they have said. They have not told me whether 99 rupees is ex interest or cum interest. As I told you, whenever nothing is mentioned, you should always take it as ex interest. Okay? And we'll have to write a note saying this. And cancelled on the same date. Fair enough. On 31st March 2, the investments were realized at par and the debentures were redeemed. You have to write up the following accounts. March 2 only, they have realize the investments and at par, so no profit loss on sale, and debentures were redeemed. Okay, so we have got everything in this sum. What all we have? We have DRR, we have DRRI, we have own debentures purchased and cancelled. We also have redemption of debentures 100% over. You have to write up the following accounts. Three accounts they've asked me: debentures, DRR and DRRI. Now, if you would see in the last lecture, in those sums, we had not made DRR. We were only focusing on own debentures, or we were seeing the debentures account. See problem now. I'll show you what I'm trying to tell you. Problem number 4, which we did. They asked me only ledger accounts of debentures and debenture interest. So we did not do DRR and DRRI. That was not, though they had given me the balance over there, but we did not need to do anything there because the accounts were not asked. In problem number 5, which I did also, they said following accounts, debentures and own debentures. So they had not asked me DRR and DRRI. But in this sum, the problem number 7, which I have, which is your module sum, in this, my dear, they have asked me not only debentures but also DRR and DRRI. So this is one major important difference in my last few sums and this one. So now when I combine the two, what happens, how am I supposed to take care of it, is what we are going to learn in this sum. Okay, so very important sum. I have star marked it, and let's do it. So first and foremost, three accounts asked, and one small thing, only one purchase has been made, so I don't need to make that six columnar working note. Come on now, I think you can do it. Where there's a single purchase, we can manage with another small working note, that purchase. Okay, shall we start? Yes, we shall. Write down in the books of nameless, no name, in the books of the company, or just a company. Not many accounts. First, we have our 12% debentures account. Since they have not asked me own debentures, and because there is a single purchase, I can do directly from my 12% debentures account. I don't need to make it. And if you want to make it, you are surely allowed to do so. No problem at all. It's up to you. About 6 lines. Second, they've asked me my DRR account, which is another 6 lines. If this would come in the exam, it should be around, I guess, 8 marks should be good enough. And for an 8 marks question, how much time you should be allotting? Not more than 12 to 14 minutes. Okay, so we should try to finish this in that much time. And next, what I have? DRRI. Please write the full forms. I can do whatever I want. I am a CA. But you, my dear, have to become one. In the exam, short forms are not allowed. So we have our three accounts which they have asked us. Okay, so let's start with the sum. First, April 1. They have given me the balance out there. So let's start with that. 16,000 12% debentures of 100 each. Okay. Just one small thing. In your investments, write into bracket the investment which is there. It is a 9% government bond. Of course, we are not making our interest on DRRI account. We are not doing all those things because they have not asked me. But this habit will always, should always be there. Oh, well, I did not do the timeline here. Did you realize that? Because there is nothing. There's only one date on which I have to do everything. Two dates. I'm not making debenture interest account, so I don't have the interest payment in between or whatever. But I just have one purchase, so I don't need the timeline for that. So you could have done it like how we learned in the last lecture. So 12% debentures, first I'm taking 141, my balance brought down. ₹16 lakh. On 1st April, we have investments, 2 lakh. 141, 2 balance brought down. In your investments, 2 lakh. And then we have got our DRR by balance brought down. ₹2,50,000. This is what is given to me. Now going further, what I have next? Next, I realize that I'm falling short. I have not met my Companies Act Section 71 requirements. So what will I do now? I will take care of that requirement. So first in DRR, I remember I need to take 25%. So immediately, I'll create more DRR, hidden adjustment, making DRR, transferring to DRR what entry I pass, P&L account debit to DRR, only for the shortfall. How much is the shortfall? My debentures are 16 lakh into 25% I want, minus 2,50,000, which I already have. So 1,50,000, I create more DRR. And same goes with my investment. Now you have to make new investment. So if I make new investment, what entry will I pass? Investment account debit to bank. So DRR I debit to bank. Amount should be at least 15% of your debentures minus what investment you already have. So 16 into 15%, we already know 2.4 lakh minus 2 lakh, remaining 40,000, let's take it now. Right? Then of course in between we would be having our debenture interest and all. But as I said, we are not making that account. So we are saved with all those working notes, with all those things. Anyways, interest payment date and all is not given. So what we would have done, you know. Next, we have 2,000 owned debentures were purchased on March and cancelled on the same date. So now on 31st March, when I purchase my own debentures, what entry normally I pass? I pass own debentures account debit to bank. And yes, I have interest also. But the interest is basically not accrued as such. Interest would have been paid because 31st March, the year is over. Interest is already paid. 31st March is only the payment date if nothing is mentioned. So actually, there is no interest accrued in this period. Reason being, 31st March is only your payment date and 31st March is only your purchase date. So there is no gap between the two. So interest accrued is anyways going to be zero. That is one important thing. But I don't need all this. Why I don't need all this? Two reasons. One, you have given me the X interest figure, rupees 99, correct? And I anyways take it at 99 rupees only. Second, if interest figure, I was making my interest on debentures account, I would need the interest figure. Now I don't even need that. Okay. And suppose come interest figure was given. Suppose come interest figure was given. Then still I would not need anything. Because 31st March only was my payment and 31st March is only my purchase date. So interest accrued anyways is zero. And therefore X interest come interest would have been the same 99 rupees. Okay, so in all the situation I understand, I have to do my accounting at simply 99 rupees. Okay, it is X interest assumed, no doubt about it. But had it been come also, my answer would not change because interest accrued will be zero. Remember, March 31st, the interest is paid. And if March 31st only you buy, nothing is going to happen. No interest will be accrued. Now coming to the point, what is going to be the situation in this? First 99 rupees you are purchasing. Now I am not making own debentures account. So I will put pass the entry directly in debentures only. Debentures account debit to bank. Okay. That is on 31st of March to bank. 99 rupees into 2000 own debentures. Directly. 1,98,000. And immediately cancel also. Now by debiting debentures, it's already cancelled, but I have not taken the profit on cancellation. So what will be my entry for the profit on cancellation and how much profit will I make? It is your face value minus your purchase price, right? So, to profit on cancellation. Here itself I'm doing it. Your face value of 2 lakh minus 1,98,000, 2,000. And I'm repeating, if you're not comfortable putting it in debentures account, you take in own debentures. No problem. Okay, if you make own debentures account, just for your CU point I'm showing you, if you make your own debentures account, how will you show it? This will happen. This will be your debentures account. This will be your own debentures. What you would have done? You would have purchased own debentures. To bank would have come here 198. Then you would have cancelled by debentures 2 lakh. Here 2 own debentures 2 lakh. Correct? And this profit would have come here to profit on cancellation. 2000 we would have done it here. Understood? So this also is an alternative. Does not matter. Okay, you can do it any way that you're comfortable with. Yes. Now going further. This is over. Just write one small note. Note. The price of rupees 99. The price of rupees 99 is assumed to be X interest. The price of rupees 99 is assumed to be X interest. Well, now going further, time for redemption. Time for redemption means what are my steps going to be? First thing, I will be receiving the interest on the investments, right? Is there any interest received on these investments? Yes, there would be, but I'm not making that account, so no need to do it. Also, I would be paying interest on my debentures, the 12%. I would have to pay. Again, will I be doing it now? No, because I have not made debenture interest account, so no need. Then, my dear, we'll be having now redemption. Let Sela Investments get the money for this redemption. So investments sold entry, bank account debit to DRRI by bank. 2,40,000. Let's sell it off. This red part is where my redemption has started. Then, after that, sold investments, now what to do? Now you have to pay off your debentures. Transfer debentures money to the debenture holders. See, whenever like this happens, okay, before even purchasing or doing anything on 31st March, you should pay your interest first, okay? And then you can do your purchasing, whatever is there. If interest paid was asked, we would have done that first, debenture interest paid. Then we would have paid on entire 16 lakh, okay? And then we would have purchased at 198. Then we will be paying interest. We have already paid the interest on that 198 also, on that 2 lakh. Okay, going further. That's about it. Debenture holders to bank will be passed, and DRR, simply we transfer it to our general reserve. And with this, I am done with my sum. 8 marks, I would suggest. Very good, a very easy 8 marks. If you get this in the exam, it's going to be a super duper lucky question for you. Okay, it's very easy, very simple. But the hidden adjustment, my dear, in this sum, you have to mark. This is very important. Student can easily miss out on these 2 points. And that's where he will be going wrong. After that, there is nothing in the sum. Absolutely easy. Okay. So, can we go further now? Problem number 6. Problem number 6. We say in the module, just before I go to 6th sum, in the module, what they have done is, they have not taken it to debenture holders, they have taken it directly to bank. Because we are not making the debenture holders account, so they have redeemed it directly. So here, you can also write to bank. Okay? So that means it's all redeemed and over. So we would have to make one more debenture holders account, so that should also be fine. You can change that. And if you write debenture holders, there's nothing wrong, but let's stick with what module has done. Going further. Problem number 6. On 1st April 1, in MK Limited's ledger, 9% debentures appeared. On 1st April, 9% debentures appeared with a balance of 50 lakh divided into 50,000 debentures of 100 each issued at par. Okay. Interest on debentures is paid half yearly on 30th September and 31st of March. Okay. 1st April 1 is my opening. 31st March would be my closing. My interest is paid on September and March. Means my year ending date and my interest date is the same. So good for me. There is no hidden adjustment of interest accrued. Last lecture, I had shown you how interest accrued adjustment happens when your year ending and your interest date are not the same. On 31st May, they purchased 8,000 own debentures at 98x interest. Okay. And same day, they cancelled it also. You have to prepare the necessary ledger accounts. Oh my God. Necessary ledger accounts means everything is open now. Okay. Which all accounts you will have to make? Let's visualize. Debentures account confirmed. Right. Interest on debentures we'll have to do now because they have not given. They have not given which accounts. So, and all ledger accounts interest will come. DRR. You will have to make. Yes, you will have to make because company should make DRR and they don't have any DRR made. There is no balance of DRR given. So you yourself have to make the DRR and not only DRR, you also have to make your investment. So this is very important. The moment they say necessary ledger accounts, now the sum is like all open and everything now we'll have to do. Is there redemption? Are my debentures getting redeemed in this year? I don't see that they are getting redeemed in this year. Like they've just said, we have purchased and cancelled. That's all we have done. But in that case also, we need to make our DRR and DRRI and keep it adequate. So these 4 accounts confirmed I have to do. And if you want own debentures also we can do. Or otherwise we can do how we did in the earlier sum. In debentures account only we will show the purchase and cancellation. Okay. So 4 accounts we need to make. Right, one question will come to your mind, right? Why am I making DRR? Why am I making DRRI when they have not asked me earlier sums why we didn't do it? So I'll show you again in the earlier sums in problem number 4, which I had They had asked me only debenture interest account. Problem number 5 which they asked, they asked me only debentures own debentures account. Problem number 6 which I'm doing, they just said necessary ledger account. So now I have to do everything. Problem number 7 which I just did, they asked me only 3 accounts. So it all depends on what is asked and what you have to make. If necessary ledger accounts, you have to make all of them. Okay, so let's start. Here we better make the timeline because we do have interest also, so we might forget that entry. So let's make a small timeline first. Not a very complicated one, it's a simple timeline. First April 1 is your balance. You're paying interest on 30th September. And 31st March is your interest paid as well as your year end. Because it is the same date, no interest accrued. Interest paid. This is opening. When have you done the purchase? 31st May, correct? Yes, 31st May. So, I can see 4. Opening balances, of course, I have. Then I have 3 things which are going to happen. On 31st May, I'm going to do purchase. On 30th September, I'll pay interest. On 31st March also, I will be paying the interest. Okay. This is what I'm showing timeline. Remember, it's not a part of the answer. It is like rough work. You can call it a CU point, which is not a part of the answer, but just for you to understand. So let's start with our accounts. MK Limited's ledger. MK Limited's ledger. First, what is the percentage of your debentures? 9% debentures. About 6 to 8 lines. Second, we decided our DRR. Another 6 to 8 lines. Third, we have our DRRI. About 6 lines. And debenture interest account. About 6 to 8 lines. One question may come to your mind, why am I not making interest on DRRI account? Reason is, I don't know where they have invested it, correct? I know they have to invest 15%, but I can't assume they invested in 4% bonds or 5% bonds. So let's not do all those things. They need to invest, that is enough for me. Where they invested, how much and which bonds they invested, I don't know that. And I can't make weird assumptions. So I need to stop it here. This should be good enough for me. Okay. So 4 accounts ready. Now, like always, I start one by one. First thing. So first, let's take our opening balances. 1st April 1, opening, we have debentures of rupees 50,141,000, by balance brought down. DRR, they don't have anything shown. DRRI, they don't have anything shown. And interest accrued opening, I don't have anything. So with this, only one opening balance I have, and I realize that they have not fulfilled Companies Act requirement. So I myself am going to create DRR. And what percentage should I create it at? 25%. So entry for creating DRR, P&L account debit to DRR on 141. By P&L. Okay. For your understanding, you can write down over there. We have to create it by ourselves. In the earlier sums, balance was given. So I took the shortfall. Here nothing is mentioned. That means everything is a shortfall. So I'll make the whole thing. 25% of my debentures, 50,00,000 into 25%. We have 12,500,000. Also, investments I'm going to make on 1st April only. The debentures. Actually, if you will see the law very clearly, if you see in deep, it says that whatever you're expecting to redeem, of that 15% at least you should have invested. But our institute has assumed in such a way that whatever be it, you should have 15% invested at all times. So we'll go with our institute stand. Okay, so to bank, we have invested now. Then after that, my 1st April opening part is over. With opening, I also had some hidden adjustments, which I'm done with. Okay, now we go for the purchase. 31st May they purchased. 31st May we purchased at rupees 98. Correct? 98 x interest, clearly given. So just one small working note I'll make. For purchase of own debentures, under that x interest price, 2000, how many we purchased? 8,000 debentures into rupees 98. See, this is also one way of presenting it. Rather than making 6 columns for just one item, I'm directly doing the working. So 7,84,000. But I will need the full amount. Why will I need the full amount? Because I will also be paying interest for the months accrued from the last payment date till the date of purchase. See my timeline. When was the last payment date of interest? 31st March only last year. And till 31st May. So how many months will that be? April, May. Add interest accrued for 2 months. Okay. This is going to be always on the face value. So 8,000 debentures, face value of 100 each. 8,00,000 into 9% for 2 months. Therefore, total amount paid, or you can also call it the cum interest price, 7,96,000. Obviously, you would be thinking, why have we taken the interest accrued? Why didn't we take it in the earlier sum? I explained that there. But here I am also making debenture interest account. So I need the entry for this. So what entry am I going to pass? See over here. Own debentures, or we can just call it debentures account debit, 7,84,000. Interest on debentures, 12,000. To bank, total 7,96,000. Okay, so let's pass that entry. In my own debentures, 31st of May, to bank, 784. In debenture interest, 31st May, to bank, 784. Oh, sorry, not 784, 12,000. Correct. So 31st May, now I'm cancelling it. 784 is what I've purchased, and it will be cancelled on the face value. So I'll be getting a profit on cancellation, two profit on cancellation. ₹8 lakh face value minus 784, what I purchased at. So two profit on cancellation will be 16,000. Okay, earlier institute used to take this profit to the capital reserve. Now they say just to profit on cancellation. So we'll also stick to that only. I hope you realized what you're doing one by one, step by step. Now, important, which I'm doing it in red now. Be careful. Now I have cancelled my 8 lakh debentures, right? They are redeemed 8 lakh in the form of cancelling them. So in this situation, I had created my DRR for the entire 50 lakh debentures, and out of the 50 lakh debentures, now 8 lakh are gone. So then, why would I keep the DRR balance for 50 lakh? I should keep the DRR balance only for the 42 lakh debentures left, correct? So the moment I cancel my debentures here, correct? I need to consider that DRR and my DRR investment should be sold to that extent. I don't need to keep that amount. Okay? So this is what is my hidden important adjustment. Understand. For 50 lakh, I had kept 12,50,000 DRR and 7,50,000 investment. But since I've cancelled 8 lakh, that 8 lakh related investment I sell, and that 8 lakh related DRR I transfer to my general reserve. Okay. So this, my dear, you have to be careful about. Okay. You, in the earlier sum, we redeemed everything. We had actually cancelled everything. So we took the whole thing to GR. But here it is such that my general reserve, I cannot take the whole thing. But I have to take relating to that 8 lakh. So this is star mark point. Remember. On 31st May only, I realize that I don't need this entire DRR. So I transfer the 8 lakh related DRR, 25% of that, like normal proportionate amount, I transfer it to general reserve. This you have to do by yourself because you cancelled debentures, so you don't need that DRR. Similarly, DRR investment, I am going to sell by bank. 15% of 8 lakh. Please star mark these two adjustments. Again, these are like hidden adjustments. The moment you purchased and cancelled your own debentures, the DRR part relating to that and the DRR investment relating to that, you transfer it to general reserve and investment you sell off. Okay, that's why I've done it in red so that you remember these adjustments. I think we're sorted now. Cancellation over, DRR transfer, DRRI sold. Whatever we had to do on 31st May is now done. Now I'm going to the next one, that is 30th of September. Interest paid. Now tell me, interest will be paid on 50 lakh or what now? No, because 8 lakh is cancelled. So interest will be paid only on 42 lakh. So entry for interest paid, debenture interest account debit. To bank, 42 lakh is your outstanding debentures into 9% for 6 months. ₹1,89,000 we pay. And 31st December also same figure. No further purchases we have done. 31st March also same figure. No further purchases we have done. No cancellations, no further purchases. And with this, my sum is over. Let's take our closing balances and finish it off. Okay. So debentures, we still have balance. 31st March to balance carry down. The 42 lakh. Relevant to the 42 lakh, you also have your balance of DRR, 10,50,000. You can cross check. The 42 lakh into 25%. Is going to be your DRR. Similarly, 42 lakh into 15% is going to be your investment. The balance, automatically that much will remain. And the debenture interest, like we always do, year-end expenditure, nominal accounts, we transfer to our P&L. So I'm doing exactly that. All accounts are closed. Sum is over. Well, let's go ahead now to the last type of questions that we have in case of conversion of debentures. Now here what we do is, instead of redeeming them, giving them cash, we are going to convert them into equity shares, or we give them a choice that you may convert into equity shares. So in that case, conversion itself is also kind of redemption, because now your debentures will not be there and they will be getting equity shares in return. So we have three problems in that area, and one by one let's see this. The entry for converting debentures into equity shares is very simple. Your debentures account debit to equity share capital on the face value to securities premium, whatever premium you're getting. So debentures also redeemed and shares issued at a premium, or normal entry can be passed. Fair enough. So let us see the problems. We'll understand it more with the problems. Problem number 8. A company has issued 20,000 13% debentures of 100 each on 1st April 1. The debentures are due for redemption on 1st July 2. The redemption terms provide that they are redeemable at a premium of 5%, and also gave option to the share, to the debenture holders, to convert 20% of their holdings into equity shares of face value of 10 at a price of 15 rupees. So basically, I'm giving the debenture holders a choice that 20% of their holdings can be converted into shares at 15 rupees each. So that is a choice that I have given. Debenture holders holding 2500 debentures did not exercise the option. So out of the 20,000 number of debentures which I issued, 2500 debentures have not taken the choice. In other words, 17,500 took the choice of converting into shares. Calculate the number of equity shares to be allotted to the debenture holders exercising the option to the maximum. So we are trying to, no accounting entries, no balance sheet, nothing involved. Simply how many number of equity shares you are going to be issuing to these debenture holders. Okay, very simple, very easy, can come for 4 marks in the exam. Okay, so let's do it. First and foremost, you have to find out how many debentures have selected the option. So as we saw, out of 20,000, 2,500 did not. So 17,500 have selected the option. Take it on your calci. 17,500 debentures are saying yes to the option. But 17,500, all will not be converted. We have given only 20% conversion choice to them. So this into 20% is the 3,500 numbers will be converted. This will be at the amount that you have to pay them. How much you have to pay these debenture holders? You have to pay them at a 5% premium. Correct? So the debentures are of 100 rupees each, and you have promised 5% premium, that is 105 rupees. So 3500 numbers into 105 is going to be the amount which I have to give them. 3,67,500. Correct? And this amount, how are you going to give them? By issuing shares at the rate of 15. So divide by 15 rupees, you will be getting 24,500 as the number of shares to be issued. It's so easy. Okay, first you calculate how many numbers have said yes. Then according to that, into whatever is the redemption value of that. Then total amount, divide by the issue price, you will get the number of equity shares. Okay, and like I said, 4 marks, easy 4 marks, cannot afford to miss it. Okay, so let's do it. Let's write down number of equity shares to be issued. Number of equity shares to be issued. Under that, A point. Debentures opting for conversion. Or debenture holders opting for conversion. 20,000 numbers minus 2,500 who are not opting. So 17,500. numbers. Actually, there's no rupees only here. We can have rupees, numbers, both. Okay, so we'll write down whatever it is. B. Number of debentures to be converted. How many numbers will be converted? 20% of 17,500. $3,500 will be the number of debentures to be converted. C is your redemption value. Is going to be 100 plus 5% premium. So 105 rupees. Redemption value per debenture is 105. Therefore, total redemption amount or total redemption value is B into C. We had done the working 367,500. But this is the amount, right? But I'm going to give in the form of equity shares. So next is your issue price per equity share. And therefore, number of equity shares to be issued is simply your D divided by E. Total redemption value divided by 15 rupees, you'll be getting it. Okay, so this is what you have to do. Now, what entry are you going to be passing for this? Right? They have not asked me the entry, but I am also thinking of the entry which will be passed. First, I'll be transferring my amount of 105 to debenture holders, right? For that, I also have to provide for the premium payable. So normally when I do premium payable, what entry I pass for premium payable? P&L to premium payable, I'll be having that amount. Then premium payable, debentures account debit to debenture holders with the full amount, correct? In this case, only for this I am telling you the entry. The total amount will be 367,500, which is going to include your debentures of 3,50,000, 3,500 debentures, 3,50,000 at 17,500 premium. Okay, so we'll be having total debentures account debit 3,50,000, premium payable on redemption 17,500. To debenture holders, 367,500. Okay, so what is the entry? This is your CU point. I'm also passing the entries for you. Debentures account debit. $3,50,000. This is only and only for the conversion part, not the remaining debentures. Debentures account debit. Premium payable on redemption. 5%, you will have 17,500. To debenture holders, 367,500. And then when you will issue them shares, debenture holders account debit, $367,500. To equity share capital on the face value, 24,500 shares into 10 rupees. 2,45,000. And to securities premium, because you're issuing it at 15 rupees. $122,500. So this will be the entry. And don't forget, premium payable on redemption, this you're going to provide from your P&L. So we would have an extra entry. I'm not doing that. I'm just making you understand the conversion related part. That P&L to premium payable, I always do 17,500. That could be the case. Okay. So these are the entries that you need to pass in case of conversion. So for 4 marks, only the initial part may not come. They might ask you entries also. So you'll have to pass these 2 entries. And you can also pass one more entry. If they ask you, that will be P&L to premium payable 17,500. That should be the one more entry that you can have. P&L debit to premium payable. $17,500. Okay, so this is when you do conversion. One thing may come to your mind, what about DRR, DRRI? Remember, DRR needs to be done for the non-convertible portion, not for the convertible portion. Convertible portion is not going to be redeemed in the form of cash. It's going to be redeemed in the form of shares. So we don't need to do it for that. Okay, so that's why DRR and all we didn't bother about. Because this is the convertible portion I'm talking about. I hope this is clear. Simple problem. Now, some more adjustments let me put. Problem number 9. Think we'll just do a little extra and we'll complete this in this lecture itself, okay? 9 and 10, just 2 problems left and my ICI module sums are over. Problem 9. Libra Limited. Important question, star mark. Libra Limited recently made a public issue in respect of the following, of which the following information is given. This would be 8 marks question if it comes in your exam. 8 marks. Number of partly convertible debentures issued, 2 lakh. Face value of 100 each. So 2 lakh numbers into face value of rupees 100. The issue price is also 100. So you have issued 2 crore rupees convertible debentures, but they are partly convertible, not party, partly convertible of 100 each. Convertible portion per debenture 60%. 60% convertible, which means 40% not convertible. Okay. Date of conversion is on expiry of 6 months from the date of closing of issue. So when I'm issuing the shares only, I know after 6 months, it is going to be converted. But the 6 months is counted from the date of closing of issue. Okay. Date of closure of subscription list. So this is the date I'm interested in. Correct? Because from the closing of issue, 6 months down the line, they are going to convert those debentures. Date of allotment of debentures 161. Rate of interest is 15% payable from the allotment date. Even if they wouldn't have told me interest is from the allotment date, normally it would be from allotment date only. Na? Application money received, I will not have interest till I allot the debentures. The value of equity share for conversion is 60 rupees. Okay, so 60 rupees is going to be your value for conversion, face value of 10. Okay. Underwriting commission of 2%. So we also have underwriting commission. Who are underwriters? We know they are the ones who promise to make good the shortfall of the issue if public does not subscribe for the shares or debentures, correct? So I'm issuing 2 lakh shares in the market. In this case, 2 lakh debentures I'm issuing. If public does not subscribe 2 lakh, public subscribe only 1,80,000, then the remaining 20,000 will be taken over by the underwriters. That is why they are charging the commission. So 2% is your underwriting commission. As per law, for debentures, the maximum commission allowed is 2.5%. And for equity shares, it is 5%. Okay. So this is 2%. Max allowed is 2.5. You can have a small adjustment in the sum where the institute says underwriters are charging the maximum commission allowed by law. Not giving you the percentage. Then they will be testing you on that 2.5% also. Small tip here. Can come as a question. Number of debentures applied 1,50,000. So you understood. I issued 2 lakh debentures in the market and only 1,50,000 have subscribed for. So the remaining 50,000 debentures have to be bought by the underwriters as promised by them. That is what underwriting is for. Interest is payable half yearly on September and 31st of March. Write relevant journal entries for all transactions arising out of the above for the year ended March 2002, including the cash and bank entries. So my dear, you have to pass journal entries, and you have to pass journal entries for everything that you are seeing for the year ending 31st March. So let us visualize what all entries you are going to be passing. First, A point, you have issued debentures of 2 crore rupees debentures. Convertible portion is there. Closure of subscription list. So that is when the money will be received. Then we'll be allotting the debentures. Then we are going to be having a conversion after 6 months. We have underwriting commission also. Then we have people have only applied for 1,50,000 debentures. Interest will be paid in between, right? Conversion is going to happen. There are so many things which are happening. So the way that you're going to do is, again, one by one, date by date, time by time, we have to do it. Properly, slowly, calmly, no confusion, no problems. So let's start. Journal entries in the books of Libra Limited. Journal entries in the books of Libra Limited. Make about 1.5 page of journal. Lots of things are happening. Also, date is important here. So also make your date column. I will be telling you the date, but you also make your column there. Come on. Shall we start? Well, let's start. First thing, you have issued two crore rupees of debentures, but public has subscribed only for 1,50,000. And that money I received on the day of closure of the subscription list. So that happens on 1st of May 1. I have received the money, bank account debit, to debenture application, bank account debit to debenture application. Only 1,50,000 public has subscribed into 100 rupees. So 1 crore 50 lakh. On 1st May, I received the money. Now the allotment took place on 1st June, but when I allot shares or debentures, I'll be allotting these 1.5 crores as well as the one that I have to receive from the underwriter. Okay. So on 1st June, I am going to pass the entry debenture application account debit. You want the narration for the first entry? You write down the narrations being debenture application money received. Being debenture application money received. So debenture application account debit. Next entry. 1 crore 50 lakh. Now the remaining 50 lakh has to be bought by the underwriters. So I'm going to debit the underwriter's account because I have to receive this money from them. Underwriter's account debit 50 lakh. The balance out of the 2 crore. Two, what is the percentage of the debentures? Where's the percentage? Point number C. Rate of interest on debentures, 15%. Okay. 2 15% debentures. Two 15% debentures, 2 crore. Being allotment of 1,50,000 debentures. Being allotment of 1,50,000 debentures to applicants and 50,000 debentures and 50,000 debentures to underwriters. Okay. Now for this also you have to pay commission to the underwriters. So next entry is going to be on the same date. Let me settle my account with the underwriters. I have to pay commission. So it's a expenditure underwriting commission account debit. Underwriting commission account debit to underwriter's account. So the commission rate is 2% of your total issue, remember, not what they have taken. Sometimes students make silly mistakes. They think we have to pay commission only on 50 lakh which they have taken. No, the commission is for the whole promise that they have made. They have promised 2 crore, correct? Even if public wouldn't have taken one debenture also, I would have, as an underwriter, purchased 2 crore. The commission is always on the total issue price. Okay, so 2% of 2 crore, 4 lakh. Being underwriting commission due. And same day I do my settlement with the underwriters, I have to get 50 lakh in the second entry. I have to pay 4 lakh for the commission. So 46 lakh settle with them. Receive the money, bank account debit to underwriters. Being amount received from underwriter for settlement. So all these entries were relating to my issue of debentures. Nowhere I have any done anything right now about my conversion or DRR or anything. It's just simply about the debentures issued. Now comes the main part. Now I have total debentures of 2 crore which I'm having right now, and for this 2 crore we remember we had said that in the beginning only I'll create my debenture redemption reserve. So I'll have to create my debenture redemption reserve. But will you create debenture redemption reserve on the entire 2 crore issue? Think. Debenture redemption reserve is only for the redemption that we have to do, not for the conversion. So see in the sum, how much convertible is there? 60%. So you have to create your DRR for the non-convertible 40%. Correct? So take on your calc. Total 2 crore I have as the debentures. In that 40% is non-convertible, which I have to redeem later on. On this 80 lakh, it will be at your regular rate of 25%. So immediately I'm creating a DRR of 20 lakh. How 20 lakh? 2 crore into non-convertible 40% into 25% normal rate. Okay, so the next entry, same day, 161. I will do this in blue now that you will understand that this is now I'm starting with my DRR related Companies Act provisions. P&L debit. To debenture redemption reserve. ₹20 lakh. How it has come? Show the working in bracket. 2 crore rupees into 40%, which is your non-convertible portion, into 25% is your rate of DRR. So very, very important star mark entry. You'll forget this otherwise. P&L account debit to DRR. I created 25% of the non-convertible portion. And now what will you do next? Okay, first let's do the narration for this entry. Being DRR reserve or DRR created, being DRR created on non-convertible debentures. On non-convertible debentures. Immediately, the moment you create DRR, nothing is mentioned in the sum, so you are going to do it all by yourself. You are also going to make your investment. Okay, so next entry, same date. DRR investment account debit. DRR investment account debit to bank. How much do I need to create? Remember, my total 2 crore debentures into again the non-convertible 40% into 15% I create for my investment. So it's coming 12 lakh. Being investment made for redemption purpose. Being investment made for redemption portion. Redemption purpose. Okay. So 1st May, I received applications for 1.5 crores. On 1st June, I allotted 1.5 crore debentures to public and 50 lakh for the underwriters. Then I settled my underwriters by paying them commission and doing the net settlement. Then afterwards, I created my DRR and I made my investment as per Companies Act. Okay. Now with this, my initial part is now over. Now after this, it is time for conversion. Now when it is time for conversion, I have to see when the conversion took place. So see the date on which you did the conversion. See the date. When was the conversion? They are saying, point number B, convertible portion is 60%. Date of conversion is expiry of 6 months from the date of closing of issue. Now I know my closing happened on 1st of May. So 6 months after that. Okay. So 1st May, that means May, June, July, August, September and end of October, right? So on 31st of October, or you can say 1st of November also, no problem. This is when I have to now do the conversion. But before converting my debentures, I also need to do something else. Yes, all these months I have been using the debentures. So don't forget before conversion to pay them interest, correct? And I'm going to pay interest only on that 60%. But I am to using 100% debentures. No problem. This interest is only on the 60% for the convertible portion. Remaining, I'll be giving them 6 monthly. Now, I've been told 6 monthly you have to pay interest. Correct or no? 6 monthly interest has to be paid. Correct? When is the interest payment date? 30th September. Oh, it's happening before. Huh? So, no, I need to pay interest first. Yes. On 30th September, see, we didn't do the timeline now. Sometimes it happens like this. This happened in October, this debenture thing, conversion. Before that, September, our interest payment date came. So let's pay the interest. Debenture interest account debit to bank, the regular interest on entire 2 crore rupees at 15%. For how many months are you going to pay the interest? Important. How many months are you going to pay the interest? You're going to be paying from the date of allotment. Remember, from the date of allotment. So 1st of June is when I have allotted. So June, July, August, September, only for 4 months into 4 by 12. So we just missed out paying the interest. We went into the convertible part. The conversion part is happening in October, but September is the date when you have your interest. So let's do that first into 15% into 4 by 12. So we are having interest 10 lakh. And then on 31st of October. Now, this is where I was talking about the convertible portion. Okay. So, 31st October. Be careful of the dates. Okay. Your interest payment starts from the allotment date. But they have told me my conversion is 6 months from the closing date. Closing of issue date. So, be careful. 31st October. Now, time to convert. But before converting, let me pay interest to those debentures which are getting converted. Debenture interest account debit to bank. Remember 2 crore debentures and how many are converting? 60%. Right? Into 15% rate. Remember debenture interest at 15%. And for how many months? We just paid till September to all of them, right? So only the month of October I have to pay. 2 crore into 60% is the 1 crore 20 lakh which is convertible into 15% interest for 1 month. So 1,50,000 I have to pay. I could be paying them now also. I can pay them even on 31st of March at the closing. That also is possible. Along with the remaining 40%, we can pay at that time also. So, Institute has paid the entire interest at the end on 31st of March. Okay. But I am passing 2 separate entries. You can also pass total combined entry at the end. I'll show that to you. Okay. Now, time for conversion. 31st October. 15% debentures account debit. How many are converting? Rupees 2 crore into 60%. So 1 crore 20 lakh are converting. But what is this 1 crore 20 lakh going to get? Let's see. The equity shares valued at 60 rupees. So 1 crore 20 lakh divided by 60 rupees. The number of equity shares issued is 2 lakh. Correct? So, debentures to equity share capital. You can make a small working note for this or you can do it the way I am doing it. 1 crore 20 lakh divided by 60 rupees. That is 2 lakh shares into the face value. 10 rupees face value, but issuing it at 60. And remember, Remaining will go to securities premium. 1 crore to securities premium. Being 60% of debentures converted, 60% of debentures converted into equity shares of rupees 10 each, into equity shares of rupees 10 each, valued at rupees 60, valued at rupees 60. They have told me to pass entries till 31st March, so I'm also doing 31st March interest entry. Again, I'm going to pay interest, debenture interest account debit to bank. Debenture interest account debit to bank. How much interest? Remember, we have already paid for the converted portion for the month. So we'll pay now for the remaining rupees 2 crore into 40%, which is still the debentures outstanding, 80 lakh into 15% for 6 months. Six lakh will be your interest for these 6 months, okay? And henceforth, the interest will remain at 6 lakh because only 80 lakh debentures are remaining now with you, okay? So this would be your entry, and you can also just transfer your debenture interest to the P&L. Last entry. P&L debit to debenture interest. You can see from the beginning, you had paid three times interest, 10 lakh plus 6 lakh and 1 lakh 50, 17 lakh 50 thousand. In fact, you can even transfer your underwriting commission. Okay, so I'll transfer that also. P&L debit. To debenture interest to underwriting commission. Your little bit different answer you may see where my institute has combined this entry, 1 lakh 50 and 6 lakh. They have passed on 31st March only the entry. On 31st March, on the payment date only, they have paid 7 lakh 50. You can do it like this also. Okay. So, the sum is over now. The convertible portion, did you understand? Did you understand the underwriting part? Application money received, settlement, so many silly mistakes we could have made on the way, in the dates, in the interest forgotten to pay for a month, interest paid for 4 months properly, you know, and then in between conversion, DRR create, DRRI create, I mean, lots and lots of things. That's why I consider this as a very, very important sum. It covers like everything which you have here, right from DRR to investment to etc., etc., like everything. Very, very important sum. Very high chances of coming 8 marks in your paper. Okay, so you have to choose like one sum, definitely it will be this one because it has everything that I want. Okay, so with this, I'm done. Coming to a last problem, number 10. Little lengthy sum we have here. Let's go for it. Problem number 10. The summarized balance sheet of convertible on 30th June stood as follows. Okay, so 30th of June. We have some share capital, we have some general reserve, we have P&L, we have DRR. Good. We also have debentures. Very good. Obviously, we will be having, right? We have other loans, we have current liabilities and provisions. Fair enough. Fixed assets we have, DRR investment we have, cash and bank and other current assets. So your balance sheet is there. The moment I see DRR, I see debentures, I see DRR investment, bell should ring. What is it? 1 crore is your debentures. Correct? Or DRR should be 25%. Is it 25%? Yes, it is. Exactly. Good for me. And is my investment enough? 15% investment, is it there? Yes, that is also there. Wow, so no hidden adjustment in the sum. The debentures are due for redemption on 1st of July. This is given on 30th June. Immediately next day, debentures are due. So very good for me. Everything is done. Immediate redemption is there. The terms of issue provide that they were redeemable at a premium of 5%. So we have to pay 5% extra. And also conferred them the option of converting 20% of their holdings into equity shares at a predetermined rate of 15.75 per share and the payment in cash. So we have given them a choice that either you take cash, okay, like normal, or 20% you can convert into shares at 15.75 rate. So how many debentures are there? We have 1 lakh debentures, correct? And we have given them the choice of converting 20% of their thing, their debentures, into shares at 15.75. Assuming, except for 100 debenture holders holding totally 25,000 debentures. So total 25,000 debentures. 100 people are holding, 500 people are holding. Makes no difference to me. For me, out of 1 lakh debentures, 25,000 debentures, the rest of them exercise the option for conversion. So basically, 25,000 debentures said, no, we don't want any conversion. So the 75,000 numbers have opted for conversion. The investments are realized at par, okay, on sale. And all transactions were done on 1st of July without any pay, without any lag, without any gap, without anything. Immediately 1st July, all things happen. What you have to do? You have to redraft the balance sheet of the company on 1st July after giving effect to the redemption. Show your calculations in respect of number of shares to be allotted and the necessary remaining cash payment. So basically, they have not asked me journal entries or ledger accounts. They've asked me to make the balance sheet again. And to make the balance sheet, I have to finish my working, right? So my working, they've said, show your calculations, kitne number of shares you have to issue, how much cash has to be paid. So what we are going to be doing now, we are going to be making our calculations. And we'll make it in such a way that while making my balance sheet, I can easily use those calculations and finish my balance sheet. Okay, so I don't need the no journal entries and all will be needed. We will do it in such a way. Okay, but my dear, journal entries, we are not passing, but they are happening. Remember, before we draft a balance sheet, everything is happening. What all will be happening? We have DRR investments we are going to sell. We are going to receive cash for that. Then we are going to be paying those debentures at a premium. So premium we have to provide for, correct? All those things have to happen. Okay, if you want, we can do it directly. If you want, we can also do it by passing entries in the exam, but you don't have the time to pass entries because this sum will come. You will not get the time to pass the entries. Okay, so choice is up to you. If you want, we will pass with the entries. So there'll be practice CU point for us. Okay, but anyways, first I have my working note which I need to show. I can in fact show it not as a working note directly, the calculations for number of shares. So come on, let's do it. Write down. First, calculation of. First point, calculation of number of equity shares to be issued. Calculation of number of equity shares to be issued. Well, particulars and numbers / rupees. Particulars and numbers. Write down. A point. Number of debentures. Opting for conversion. Number of debentures opting for conversion. We have 1 lakh debentures. Out of that, 25,000 are not ready for conversion. So remaining 75,000 numbers are ready for conversion. So number of debentures to be converted. Now you know those 75,000 are saying yes, but those 75,000 entirely is not convertible, right? Number of debentures to be converted is only 20% of that. So out of 1 lakh, 75,000 said yes, we'll convert. 75,000, only 20% conversion is allowed. So 15,000 debentures will be converted. But how much do I have to pay these debentures? Okay, so C point. Amount payable, or write down redemption value of above debentures. So I have to pay the 15,000 numbers into, I think we have a premium, na? We have to pay at a premium. 5% premium. The debentures are of 100 rupees each, right? So it will be at 105. You have to pay 15,000 debentures into 105. 15,75,000 rupees. Needs to be paid. And how are we going to give this? We are going to give this at by equity shares valued at 15.75. Okay, so number of, or issue price, write down issue price. Per equity share 15.75, therefore, number of equity shares issued is C upon T, 1 lakh. Remember, you're issuing 1 lakh equity shares of rupees 10 at rupees 15.75. So out of total 1 lakh debentures, how many debentures got converted? Not 25,000, not 75,000, only 15,000 we have paid right now. Only these many we are going to convert. Okay, so remaining out of 1 lakh, the 85,000 people, we have to still pay them cash. So that is my second part. Cash payment to be made. cash payment to be made. Cash payment to be made. Under that, total number of debentures. Still 1 lakh. Not 1 lakh. How many were the debentures? Yeah, 1 lakh. Correct. Out of that, less debentures to be converted. Here, sometimes students make silly mistakes, okay? They take 75,000 at times, they take 25,000, I don't know how, but they make silly mistakes. Be careful. Therefore, number of debentures or balance, 85,000 debentures. Redemption value, 105. So 89,25,000 is the amount that needs to be paid to these debentures. Okay, so actually now based on this, I can make my balance sheet. I can easily make my balance sheet. Okay, but I am also going to now show you your journal entries. Okay. Why am I doing those journal entries? Just simply CU point for practice sake. That's all. So come on, write down journal entries as a CU point, extra point, not asked in the sum, just for practice sake. Journal entries. All the things are happening on 1st July, remember. 1st July. So there is no interest as such, nothing has to be done about interest. 30 June balance sheet is given and this is 1st July. First, time for redemption. So first what I need to do is I need to sell my investment. So I'm selling bank account debit to DRRI. They said we sold the investments at par. Remember, we were having proper investments, proper DRR balance. Had we not been having that, I would have created more investments. I would have created my DRR more. We had done it in an earlier sum also. But here I had 25%, 15%, exactly what I wanted. So bank to DRRI, investment sold 15 lakh. Then, after that, I will transfer that DRR also to general reserve because my work is over with that. This we can do later also, but I'm finishing it first. The DRR was 25 lakh. Basically, I'm done with my DR related stuff. Debenture, redemption, reserve and investments. Now, time for redemption. First, I'll provide for the premium, okay? Premium on redemption. From where will you provide the premium? 5% you have to pay extra, remember? From my P&L. To premium payable or premium on redemption. P&L debit to premium on redemption. I have P&L balance, right? Yes, I do have. But I have less balance. I think I'll need more premium, right? The debentures are 1 crore into 5%. No, I can manage. 1 crore debentures. Into 5%. P&L debit to premium on redemption of debentures. Now the total amount due to debenture holders. Total amount due to debenture holders, 13.5% debentures debit, 1 crore. Premium on redemption of debentures debit, 5 lakh. Two debenture holders, 1 crore 5 lakh. See, I'm just passing these entries for practice. I'm repeating it, okay? You can directly make the balance sheet also. That's not an issue. Then, now time for paying them. Debenture holders account debit. 1 crore 5 lakh. But all of them I'm not paying to bank, okay? I am going to also convert some of them. So, for converting, it will be equity share capital. I have my working note ready. Where's my equity share capital? We're going to issue 1 lakh shares at 15 rupees, 15.75, okay? One lakh shares into rupees 10, that is your face value. Ten lakh to securities premium. One lakh shares into 5.75. And remaining will be paid through cash bank. 89,25,000. Okay, so we have done this working. See, this is here. And the 1 lakh, 15,75,000 that I'm paying is here. Okay, so when, suppose I wouldn't have passed the entries, I was directly making the balance sheet, I would have straight away taken it to share capital. All my working is here only, so I know about it. Correct? So, DRR transfer to GR, bank done, premium provided, debenture holders paid off. Guess everything is over now. So, now based on this, I'm going to do my journal, my balance sheet. Okay, so let's start making our balance sheet. Which notes are you going to need in your balance sheet? Let's see the notes. Share capital we would not be really needing, but we'll keep that. Share capital, we'll have our reserves because we have some things in the reserves. PNL all, we have made some changes. Then we'll be having our bank. I think that should be enough. Nothing else we need, okay? So let's make your balance sheet. Depending on what all are the items in the balance sheet, we will make our heads of the balance sheet, okay? So let's start. Not too many things. We can straight away do it. Come on, make your format. My format is almost done. You have to make it. Well, So starting with my equity and liability, share capital reserves we have. We also have in the sum some loan. Okay, so I'll also write non-current liabilities. Under current liabilities, we have got liabilities and provisions. Okay, so we can just write down short-term provisions. It is the base which is given to me, plus what all changes I have made. I've issued debentures. I've converted the debentures. I have paid them off, whatever be it. In assets, I have fixed assets. I have DRR investments which I sold. I have some cash and bank balance, and I have others. So I'll just write down cash and cash equivalents and others. Okay. Balance sheet of Convertible Limited as at 171. So come on, let's start with my assets first. I'll give you 2 minutes, then complete your format first. So let's start. First, we have our assets PPE 1 crore 60 lakh. Cash and cash equivalents. Next item I have the DRR investments. We sold it, and cash equivalents, I'll add that amount, okay? Plus investments sold. 15 lakh. In my cash and cash equivalents, I've not written the balance, but I'm writing the investment sold. Next item I have cash and bank 75 lakh. So I'm writing that balance. And other current assets 2 crore as it is. Okay, so my asset side is over and investments are also sold. Next, I have share capital now. My share capital was 5 lakh of 10 each and we also converted some shares. Remember, we converted 10 lakh. We have 10 lakh amount as your equity shares. So we have issued, subscribed and paid up. First, we had 5 lakh. We issued 1 lakh more from our working note 1. So 6 lakh. Equity shares of rupees 10 each. I don't know authorize, so I'm putting a dash there. And out of this 6 lakh, I know 1 lakh shares have been issued other than cash. We have actually converted them. So just writing the note in that are issued for consideration other than cash. Share capital is over. Let's see my reserves. First reserve I have is general reserve. In the inner column, because we had transferred our DRR to the general reserve, right? So plus DRR transferred. 25 lakh. And next we have P&L, 10 lakh. From P&L, only one thing I did. I provided for the premium. Premium on redemption. 5 lakh. And now while doing the redemption, what all things had happened? Oh, first, let me complete. Debentures, 1 crore. We have redeemed. 65 lakh is the other loans we have. Long-term borrowings. And current liabilities, 1 crore 25 lakh. So in those debentures, what did we do? 1 crore plus 5 lakh. For that 5 lakh premium, I've done my effect. What did I do? 1 crore 5 lakh then? I issued them shares, 10 lakh. I issued the shares at a premium 5 lakh 75,000. So I've still not taken that premium. Securities premium. And finally, I have my cash paid. I had paid some 89,24,000 by way of cash. Correct? 89,25,000. So less debentures paid. 89,25,000. Now I think you can tally your balance sheet. Okay? Many times students forget securities premium. Okay, so be careful. 15 lakh 75,000, 10 lakh shares, 575 premium. Okay, so you can tally it. Come on, do it yourself now. So balance sheet tallied with a total of 3 crore 60 lakh 75 thousand. Okay, so with this, all my institute module sums are over. We have done all the types of adjustments which could come. We have done all the I've done a little extra only when what institute has given. Some things extra we have done so that we are properly prepared for the exam. Okay, so do this chapter well. We have good chances of it coming in the exam. And any doubts, any problems, you're not understanding something, definitely give me a call. You already have my number. And wish you all the best. Study well. Enjoy. Keep smiling.